Professor R. S. Deshpande, today we discuss the problem MI of T section. This is a T section, and we have to calculate moment of inertia about x x axis. Then here this is a top flange and this is a web. Then considering as section 1 for top flange and consider web as a section 2. Then this is a reference axis x and this is a reference axis y. Okay. Then here we have to calculate in the first B1 that is equal to 250 mm given data. Then B1 that is equal to 25 mm. Then B2 that is equal to 25 mm. D2 that is equal to 150 mm. Okay. These are the dimensions which are provided in the problem. Then here this is B1 is the width of section 1 and D1 is the depth of section 1. B2 is the width of section 2 and D2 is the depth of section 2. Then here first we calculate the area A1 that is B1 into D1 250 into 25. Then here the area A1 you will get finally 6250 mm square. Then A2 area for section 2 150 into 25. Then after calculation, then A2 will get 3750 mm square. Okay. Once we find out the areas of section 1 and 2, then we calculate moment of inertia or the y1 and y2 distance y1 and y2. Then y1 is here, y1 is the distance from reference axis x to the section to the centroid of section 1. Then that distance is 150 plus 25 divided by 2, then 150 plus 12.5, then final you will get the value 150, that is you will get final value 162.5 mm. Then similarly we calculate y2 is 150 divided by 2, that is 75 mm. Okay. Once we find out the values of y1 and y2, then you calculate the values of y1 that is equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus divided by y1 plus y2. This is simple formula, a1 plus a1. Then we put up the value 6250 into y1 162.5 bracket term plus a2 3750 into 75 divided by a1 6250 plus 3750. Then y1 that is equal to 129.125 mm. Okay, this is the value for y bar. Then once we find out the values of y bar, then we calculate h1 and h2. H1 and h2 is the distance between the centroidal axis and reference axis for section 1 and 2. Then here y1 is 162.5 and y-bar is 129.125. Then which one is greater? Y-bar is greater. y1 is greater, then y1 minus y1 that is equal to 162.5 minus 129.125, then that is equal to,
then we will get the values of h1 54.125 mm.
Then y2,
which one is greater value? Y2 is 75 mm and y1 is 129.125.
So y1 minus y1, 129.125 minus 75. Then
final value you will get y2,
33.375 mm. This is
the value for the h2. Once we get the values of h1 and h2, then by applying the parallaxis theorem,
Ixx that is equal to Ixx1 plus A1x1 square plus Ix2x2 plus A2x2 square. Okay. Then here we calculate Ixx1, Ix1, x1 that is equal to b1 d1 cube upon m, that is the formula for rectangular section for section 1. Then here put up the value, b1 is 250 into 25 cube divided by 12. Then after calculation we get the values of Ixx1, 7.031 into the 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Then once we find out the moment of inertia about the xx axis for section 1, then we calculate moment of inertia about xx axis for section 2. Ix2 that is equal to b2 d2 cube divided by 12. Substitute the value, b2 is 25 into 150 divided by 12. Then we after calculation we get the values of Ixx2, 325.52 into 10 raised to 3 mm raised to 4. That is value for moment of inertia about xx axis for section 2. Once we find out all the values of moment of inertia about the xx axis for section 1 and 2, then we put up that value in the parallel axis theorem, then we get the values of moment of inertia about the xx axis for whole section of T. We just put up the value, Ixx1 is 7.031 into 10 raised to 6 bracket complete plus A1 is already calculated, 6250 into H1 is 54.125 square bracket complete plus Ixx2 325.52 into 10 raised to 3 bracket complete plus A2 already calculated, 37.750 into H2. H2 is here 33.75 375 bracket square. Then finally you get the values of moment of inertia for about xx axis for whole section of T. Then 25.303 into the 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Okay. This is the value of xx. 25.303 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Okay. Here, this is the problem and that is the solution of that problem. This is actually T section.
distinction which is made by top flange and wave. Then we get the T section. First of all, in the problem, the dimension of top flange and wave section, it has been given. Then according to the data which are provided in the T section, then finally we need to find out the values of moment of inertia about the x-x axis for whole section of T. Then here the data is provided. The width of top section, it is represented by small letter b, that is b1, 250 mm, and similarly depth will be given 25 mm. Then b2, that is equal to 25 mm. Here this is the problem which is regarding for T section. Then whatever data will be provided, then here which is made by top and wave section, T section which is generally made by top section and top flange and wave. Then the dimension, that is the top flange width and depth, that is represented by as section 1, B1 and D1, and wave section as considered as section 2, B2 and D2. Then here that data is provided. Then according to that data, first we calculate the areas of the section. Areas of the here the areas of the different section. First we need to calculate that area. The area A1, that is 250 into 25. Then you will get 6250 mm square. And area for section 2, 150 into 25, that is equal to 3750 mm square. Once we find out the areas of the section 1 and 2, then we calculate distance from reference axis to centroid, that is y1 and y2 for section 1 and 2. For section 1, y1, that is 150 plus 25 divided by 2, that is 162.5 mm, y2, that is 75 mm. Then we calculate y bar, a1 y1 plus a2 y2 upon a1 plus a2. Then y bar, that is equal to 129.125 mm. Then once we get the values of y bar, then you can easily calculate the h1 and h2, that is the distance between the reference axis and centroidal axis. H1, that is equal to y1 minus y bar. Then finally you will get a value 54.125 mm. H2, that is equal to y bar minus y1, that is equal to 33.375 mm. Then once we get the values of a1, a2, y1, y2, y bar and h1 and h2, then applying a parallel axis theorem, ixx, that is equal to ixx1 plus a1 h1 square plus ixx2 plus a2 h2 square. Then here we calculate moment of inertia about xx axis for section 1. The formula will be ixx1, ix1 x1, that is equal to b1 d1 cube upon 12. Then ix1 x1, that is equal to 7.031 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Then once we get the values of moment of inertia about the section 1, about the x-axis for section 1, then we calculate the moment of inertia about the x-axis for section 2. The formula will be ixx2, that is equal to b2 d2 cube upon 12, that is equal to put up the value we already calculated, or some values are given in the dimension in the T section. Then we put up the value, then we will get the values of moment of inertia about x axis for section 2, 325.52 into 10 raised to 3 mm raised to 4. Once we know or once we get the values of ixx1, ixx2, a1, a2, h1, h2, then we directly that value put in the formula for the parallel axis theorem. Then finally, we get the values of the moment of inertia about the x-x axis for the whole section, that is T section. The same procedure for inverted T section. In this problem, we follow some steps. Means in the first step, we calculate the areas of the section. In the first step, we divide the section into two parts, and we find out the areas of that section.
Then once we find out the areas of the section, then we calculate y1, h1, h2, and then applying parallaxis theorem and find out the moment of inertia about x-axis for section 1 as well as for section 2, and all the values of moment of inertia about x-axis for section 1, 2, then areas for section 1, 2, and h1 and h2 in the given formula. Then finally we get the values of moment of inertia about the x-axis for the whole T-section. Okay. Thank you.